seawall construction project. And I'll be the project manager of the city for this project. Today we have with us Peter Rice, our director of public works.
And good evening.
And we have our design engineers who are also going to be representing us in the field as construction inspectors for Ty and Bond. We have Julia Calverton and Dennis Moran. We have a representative also from the contractor, which is ACK Marine, Kevin Butcher. And today we're going to be talking about the project and information. And at the end, we'll be having some questions. This is a combination of hybrid meeting with the Zoom and in-person meeting. So I'll turn it over to our consultant, Tanya Bond.
Thank you, everybody. So we have a very, very brief PowerPoint to just give a quick presentation and overview of the project. For those of you that are not aware, the project is at 95 Mechanic Street, proximate to the wastewater treatment plant in the city. And the existing, there's an existing pier and wharf that is shown, that the existing conditions or the prior conditions are shown on the screen right now, a couple of photos. Ty and Bond is the design engineer. We're located right on Keys in the city. And ACK Marine was the most responsive low bidder that was awarded the project. They're out of Quincy, Massachusetts. They specialize in waterfront and marine construction. So as I mentioned, the project site's at 95 Mechanic Street. There's an existing backfilled granite pier that a portion to the south has been rebuilt approximately 10 to 15 years ago. And the proposed reconstruction of this portion of the wall will be similar in nature. There was a timber wharf that failed a couple of years ago that was then removed, what was remaining removed by the city in, I believe, 2019. As part of that this project that will not be reconstructed. However, it may be reconstructed at a further future time. You can just see that the bridge to Pierce Island is just to the north of the site, and it's right off Mechanic Street next to the wastewater treatment pump station as well. So the purpose of this project is to replace the existing seawall, more or less in kind. It will resemble the historic nature of the seawall. It will be in the original footprint, and we want to stabilize the pier to improve its function and the safety of the public as well as the surrounding properties. Here's a quick photo of what's out there now during low tide. You can see the bridge for Pierce Island in the background. The seawall is in poor condition. It's very old. The timber wharf that was there that held the La Casa,
Alcava.
La Cava, buildings has all been removed by the city previously before construction. The wall is unstable. It's in the risk of collapsing. So the goal, as I mentioned, is to restabilize the wall and ensure that the public is safe. The railing is in need of repair as well. So the entire area will be restabilized, reconstructed. There'll be a new wall that's adequately supported, et cetera. Sorry, Peter, please. Another photo of the site. You can see the existing wall that's in poor condition. Where the photo was taken, that wall is in very poor condition. So it's almost a rubble wall. So that wall will be restabilized and reconstructed. Here's a quick view of the proposed reconstruction. Although the outside will look like the existing wall with the granite blocks, it's actually supported by a much more robust and current foundation that's supported by H piles that are driven to bedrock, which is plus or minus 30 feet, as well as a large, what they call a pile cap, which is a concrete foundation that supports the granite wall. And the granite wall is more of a veneer. There's a structural concrete wall behind the granite wall to support the backfill and the pier itself. On behalf of the city, obtained permits from New Hampshire DES. So as well as the Conservation Commission back a few years ago. So the permitting is complete, the contract is well aware of the permits. Project schedule, the contractor, ACK Marine, is looking to get out there in the next couple of weeks. They're going to start by demoing the wall. The goal is to get the existing wall removed by August. Then they're going to work on reconstructing the new wall, which is plus or minus 145 feet. Their goal is to complete construction in October, and then the final walkthrough, site cleanup, restoration to be completed before Thanksgiving. General hours of working are 7 a.m. to 6 p.m. to allow for flexibility due to the tides, as that's always changing. For questions and comments for the public, Ray, as he mentioned, is the project manager on behalf of the city. His contact information is up there. It will also be on the city's website for current projects that will be updated weekly to give the public general information on the project, as well as schedule and potential impacts, although that we're not anticipating any during construction. If you have any questions, feel free to reach out to Ray. And I will turn it open to questions for the public. I'm not sure if anybody online, I saw we have one or two participants.
Yep. So this presentation will be put on the city's website, and there will be opportunities to interact with the contract, with the project via Ray Pizzullo. The biggest concerns that I would want to make sure people understand is just more coordination type activities. If there's something that, you know, a special event or something like that, we know there's a restaurant down in the area that needs deliveries, there's boat access and things like that that need to be maintained. So that's about the scope of it at this time. So if anybody has any questions, go ahead and raise your virtual hand. Seeing none, we can, as I said, we'll post this presentation, and we appreciate folks showing up, and we will look forward to having a successful project. Thank you very much. We will now be ending this meeting. Turn off the recording.